So yes, we are talking about plant-based meats. It's a part of a sector we call alternative proteins. And we believe it's the most straightforward way to save us from a biodiversity collapse. Biodiversity collapse is a part of climate change. I think personally it's more urgent than just the temperatures, because we get all the time the data on 1-2 degrees, etc., etc. The data will not save us, and the technology alone will not save us. So understanding if there is something super urgent, in this case, biodiversity collapse means that we lose diversity, for example, when we deforestate, we cut trees to make space for the feed for the animals and for the beef specifically. And diversity means in agriculture, if we just rely, for example, on soy or wheat, that is also not good. So if we really see that we have, for example, extinction of species and we are deforestating the Amazon, then that is not very polarizing. I mean, nobody likes to deforestate the Amazon, right? I mean, if you ask any children, for example, that's they really would say this is terrible, if you ask me as well. So we're talking about plant-based meats, what I call the next generation, because everybody knows Impossible, right? Impossible Burgers, Beyond Meat, that is burgers. Why nobody does the whole cuts? It's because it's difficult. So we need a technological switch. It's like when we had internet, you know, we had a better bandwidth, then we allowed, you know, the cloud to grow. But in this case, technology allows us to go beyond the burgers and to do what we call whole cuts, because those are about 80% of meat purchases. 80% of meat purchases in retail are whole cuts. So it's not that the people don't want to have an alternative to that. It's because there is no alternative to that right now. So imagine chicken breast, chicken fillets, beef steaks, pork, loin, right? Some people would like, especially Generation Z, they really are looking for that. And so we are working on developing the technology, the platform, so it's a B2B, all right? And we don't do that with a 3D printer now. We do that with a big machine at scale, about 1 ton of production per hour. But we started with the machine, and we still use this machine when we develop the new prototypes with the top chefs. So we work with number 3 best restaurant in the world, Disfrutar, Barcelona. They were XL Bulli. They were working with Ferran Adrià 20 years now. They're number 3 in the world, and we developed together the formulations for this. They're based on yellow pea protein, okay? So yellow pea protein is what is inside, for example, a Beyond Meat. But instead of a burger, you will see there tacos, that is plant-based pulled meat, and plant-based chicken, which is a breaded whole cut, okay? Then, what I think really activates the transition, what we see in the last decades when the climate tech transition, it really was driven by ethical reasons, you know, for humanity, for the planet. But unless you find product superiority and unless you're able to scale, so if unless you get the 3 of them, this is not activating this kind of switch. So, for example, we got the Toyota Prius, right? The beginning was not very exciting because it was sustainable, but it didn't. It was better for the environment, but not better for you. But if you are getting a car, for example, an example is a Tesla, it goes from 0 to 60 in 2 seconds. You know, I'm Italian, but a Ferrari cannot do from 0 to 60 in 2 seconds. There is no way. In France, they have a Bugatti. The Bugatti is, I don't know, 2 million. It cannot go from 0 to 60 in 2 seconds. So it was better for environment, but also you need to scale. So, you know, it took a lot of work to scale these machines. But then it needs to be superior to the carbon counterpart. In our case, for example, it needs to be the same, right? Better for the environment, okay? Efficiency, not with a printer, but with a big machine. As I said, we really can do that. We launched today the pilot plant in Barcelona. And we launched today in Barcelona in the first restaurant. So if you come, please, you can come and write us an email, novamit.com, team@novamit.com, and you can visit us. Product superiority, so the first generation were not very exciting, right? Just for vegan and vegetarians. But now Generation Z and also millennials like me looking for something like with the fibrosity, with the... this was actually tested in a stealth mode in a steakhouse, in the what it was called the Wagyu menu. So it was the Wagyu, $300 per kilo. And then the chef, our collaborator, put this one as a future of meat. And we used the technology I developed myself at the beginning from bioengineering when I was using these machines for doing bioprinting to create organs. And then I adapted this technology. I brought this to Ferranadria. I brought this to Celler de Carroca. They are number one in the world for many years, and in Barcelona area. And then we opened a startup with this technology. We were able to create these microfilaments that you see here. This is the switch, right? I mean, not just the burgers. You create a texture, not just the taste, but also less ingredients in the ingredients list, so it's better nutritionally, and also this texture. So we can do chicken breast. We can do pulled meat, pulled pork, for example. You can find it over there. And the first target, we are targeting the easy one. The easy one is the cheap fillets that you can see in the supermarkets. They're not very good for the environment, and they're not very good at all. I asked our collaborator chef, the number three in the world, and I asked them, are you able to cook these kind of cheap fillets that is kind of, I don't know, 70% of what most people buy? Are you able to cook this properly without all the water going out? And he said, no, there is no way. Even the good chefs, we are not able to make this work. So I think it's not difficult to find an alternative that is better nutritionally and superior. Because if you see, for example, in terms of being healthy, this is not very healthy. These fillets normally, especially the red meat, it has some downsides. For example, 18% more probability of colon cancer. Processed meat in general is carcinogenic, according to the World Health Organization. And the organic and grass-fed, they are better in terms of they're healthier, they don't have antibiotic, estrogen maybe, but they're not sustainable. This is very important, very important. If you have a beef in a huge space of land, it's better for the animal, but it's not better for the planet. We try to do both, right? But you understand, right? The reason why we have intensive farming is because of efficiency. It means intensive farming uses less resources than organic grass-fed. Is this clear? Check it, because it's something that people think it's better for the environment, grass-fed, yes. But then if everybody buys organic grass-fed, it will be super expensive and it will be not that much protein for everybody on the planet. All right, but if you compare this with fruits, vegetables, and legumes, they are both much worse for your health and for the planet. And also, I can say these plant-based meat alternatives, they are not yet made to substitute whole foods, okay? This is an alternative to meat, to protein, but you still need to eat fruits, vegetables, legumes. They are better for you than plant-based meat alternatives. All right? This is very important. All right, so John Doerr talked about some points, right? He said about climate change. I will talk specifically about biodiversity collapse, because I think it's one part of climate change. We don't talk much about that. We talk a lot about the degrees. Right? People don't care about the degrees that much. Maybe here in Los Angeles, yes, but I mean, in other parts of the world, the rich part of the world that are not at this latitude, we really care much more about biodiversity collapse, which really means the deforestation of the Amazon and the tropical areas of the world. And we are responsible. So, my solution that is not mine, but I just made a summary of what is, according to other scientists that are much better than me. So, renewable energy transition is going beyond the fossil fuels. This is according the same for climate change in terms of temperature. Then, three that are very, very focused on biodiversity collapse directly is deforestation. Land-based diets that are better in terms of land use, water use, CO2, methane, etc. And no fishing zones. And the good thing is the three of them, if you find an alternative that is better for us in terms of its better in taste, in texture, and the nutritional properties are good for us. If we solve alternative proteins in the format of very good plant-based meat alternatives, we really address deforestation, plant-based diet, and no fishing zones. All right? Just, I don't want to show data, but in the last 30 seconds, I will show you data. 41% of deforestation of tropical areas. So again, 41%. 41, it means almost half of deforestation of tropical areas is beef alone. Beef alone, right? Second, annual CO2 emission from deforestation byproduct in Brazil. The number one is beef. Number two, doesn't matter. It just, if you combine all of them together, it's strange, right? I thought it was a mistake, but the sources are there. I can share this with you. So really, beef is very, very bad, and you need to find an alternative. And this image, I'm 35 years old, so I'm not very young, but I remember, I mean, I was in the transition, right? And when you travel in rural areas, it was a disaster here. when we saw this, but now we don't see this anymore. And this is a problem. This is a part of what we call baseline, shifting a baseline syndrome. It means we get used, and we think it's better for us. We get used. For example, the ocean in the 1800s was not like it is right now. And we need to understand that when humanity, humans are not very good when we pass through generation, we are not very good in understanding the change. We don't see what our grandparents were seeing, so we think it's normal that we don't have any more animals like we had. So please, biodiversity collapse, so we avoid going to Mars, which should not be the next step there. And last slide. This is interesting. It's a slide that personally I find very interesting because I have two children. One is 2 years old and one is 7 months old. And if you think about, for example, the new generation, what you really don't want is that they are not able to see, I don't know, the natural world as we see. No rhinos, no giraffe. So I'm going away, but I will leave this. And it's vertebrate species with less than 1,000 individuals left. 1,000. 1,000 left. Push play and go away. Okay? Novamid.com is one of the startups working on this. Maybe not the best, not the strongest, but we are doing our part. And if you want, join us at Novamid.com. Thank you.